Hey guys, welcome. This is Kino. I am playing on the Betrayin Game Monarch server, and today I'd like to show you how to create hidden doors using the Craftbook Player Detector and Craftbook Player Inventory Sensor. So I've put up a little setup here with a hidden door, and let me show you how to use it. So if you walk close to the door, and you walk in the left corner, nothing happens. Once you walk to the right corner, it opens. And if you move back a bit, you will see the door closes again. It works both ways. And this is very cool to use. You can always hide your doors like this, no one will ever notice. So let me show you how to create these Craftbook ICs. First of all, for the player detector, we are going to use a block with a sign on the front. On the second line, type MC1272 within the brackets and an S outside. And on the third line, you can specify the range. This can be anything from 1 to 10. If you specify a higher number, the IC will still be working, but the downside is it will still have a 10 block range. So let's put a lamp on top for indication. And you see it turns on. And if you move away, it turns off. So now let's see what size the range is. It turns on. It turns off. On, off. And let me use this technique to show you what the actual shape is. As you can see, this is edged, so this is at least a circle. Now let's get in range, and if we jump, we see the light flashing, which means it is actually a sphere. This is the basic player detector. Now let me show you how to create the player inventory sensor. It's again a block with a sign on the front, and on the second line type MC1269. And an S outside of the brackets. On the second line, again, the range 1 to 10. And on the fourth line, you can type the item a player needs to hold in order for the IC to activate. So let's try it out with dirt at first. There we go. It says the player inventory sensor is created. A lever on the back and the lamp on top. This lamp, again, is just for indication. And you see it turns on because we have all the dirt in our inventory. If we move back a bit, you see it turns off. And if I throw away my dirt, you again will see it turns off. There we go, we have our inventory sensor. So now let's put up an item that's a bit more difficult to detect. I have done some testing. And actually the enchanted items will not work. So let's try just a special item. In this case, cracked couple of our cracked bricks, which has an item ID of 98.2. And since I do have some in the inventory, it does activate. If I throw it away, it deactivates. It's very important to pick a very special item for this. So only you know what the key is to open your door. And you can use this as a door here. In this case, I've used the normal player detection with a range of 4. And I have inverted the signal with a torch here. So this piston will actually be turned on when I am out of the area. But since this only powers the bottom piston, I had to put a block on top, so the top piston would be powered at the same time. And this inverter actually creates the door. Now you notice it is offset, since I need to travel all the way to this corner to get it opened from this side. And from this side, it opens really quickly. That's because I've placed this IC just a bit offset, so the entrance is a lot harder to find than the exit. You can actually place it a bit further back, and that would create an equal amount of space on both sides. A downside about that is that you need to increase the range, and the bigger the range, the further you need to be away from it for the door to stay closed. As you can see, I need to be this far away. If I get a bit closer, the door opens. So you need to have quite some area where no people can move, since it will trigger the door. Again, if you use the key here, the door will only be triggered if you have the right item in your inventory. And, well, I think this kind of concludes the tutorial. You can use this to power, just like this, a small 1x2 door. I actually have used this connected to a 2x3 completely hidden door, so you have a flat wall where you can enter. Well, actually, let me show that for a second. I'll be back. Okay, so here we are. As you can see, this wall is nothing more than just a plain wall. And the only thing that actually makes it look a bit different is the torches above. And as you can see, if I move closer to the door, it will open. It's a seamless door, so you will not see anything. If I move back, the door closes again. And this way I can actually move back and forth without anyone knowing there's a door here. This is using the same principle with the item detection in the player's inventory. So I hope this gives you a few nice ideas. You can also use it for dispensers to shoot fire charges or arrows. Feel free to experiment. I hope you have enjoyed this tutorial. If you've liked it, please leave a like, and I will see you later.